Assalamu alaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Brothers and sisters, in the authentic hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, the best charity is to feed a human being. So if you think about it, in this month of Ramadan, when we are all staying away from food, and there's still somewhere close to 960 million people that are chronically hungry, that will probably still go to sleep today with some sort of hunger, and that will have felt the pangs of hunger throughout their life. You know, you think about this, Ikhwani, there really is a need for us to follow this hadith of Rasulullah. You know, as I've been doing tafsir of the Quran, and I've been falling through the themes that are very much apparent through the tafsir of the Quran. One of the themes that Allah Azza wa Jalla talks about again and again and again and again throughout the Quran is about feeding the poor. Look at Surah Balad. This is Surah number 90, verse number 11. What does Allah Azza wa Jalla say? Allah says, "Falaqtaham al-aqaba." He has yet to. Meaning human beings, they want success, they want guidance, they want to go to Jannah. He has yet to do the aqaba. What does aqaba mean? Meaning he has yet to do something that of something great, something which is huge. He has yet to do the steep climb, you know? That's called aqaba. Then Allah says, "Wama adraka min aqaba?" Do you want to know what aqaba really is? Then Allah says, "Fakku raqaba." It is either to free a slave, aw it'aman fi yawmin dhi masqaba, or to feed a poor human being in a yawm, on a day of severe hunger. Yeah? On a day of severe hunger, if you were to feed a human being, this is called aqaba with Allah Azza wa Jalla. What is aqaba? The great achievement, the great steep climb, the great deed in the eyes of Allah Azza wa Jalla. It's either freeing a slave, or it is to feed a poor human being on a day of great hunger. Right? أَوْ إِطْعَامٌ فِي يَوْمٍ ذِي مَسْقَبَ يَتِيمًا ذَا مَقْرَبَ أَوْ مِسْكِينًا ذَا مَطْرَبَ. To either feed an orphan who is close in relationship to you, or a poor human being who is really going through lots of difficulty. And this is what Allah Azza wa Jalla calls aqaba. Also Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says so in Surah Al-Insan, which is a surah that was revealed because Fatima radiallahu ta'ala anha decided to feed her food instead of eating herself. She decided to give her food away, herself and her and Ali radiallahu ta'ala anhu's food, and also Hassan Hussein's food radiallahu ta'ala anhu ajma'in. He decided to give that food away to a beggar, to an orphan, and to a prisoner of war. Now, beggars are poor, prisoners of war are non-Muslim, orphans are just have no one to look after. So if you think about it, the issue of feeding poor, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in Surah Al-Insan, you know how he describes it? وَيُطْعِمُونَ الطَّعَامَ عَلَى حُبِّهِ مِسْكِينًا وَيَتِيمًا وَأَسِيرًا. And they feed out of the love of Allah a miskeen, an orphan, a poor person, a yatim, an orphan, or asira, or a prisoner of war. So if you see, my brothers and sisters in Islam, the issue of feeding poor doesn't have to be someone who's absolutely dying. But if you feed someone who needs to be fed, like a fasting person, like a beggar, like someone who is really poor, whether on a day of great hunger, or on a day where they are chronically hungry, then wallahi, this is one of the most beloved deeds to Allah Azza wa Jalla. And walhamdulillah, the Prophet ﷺ, it was he who said, verily that person does not believe, he doesn't believe. Three times, who doesn't believe, Ya Rasulullah ﷺ? The one who goes to sleep whilst his stomach is full, but his neighbor is hungry. Today, in the global village that we live in, our neighbors are not only the people next door to us, our neighbors are people that could be in a different country, but we know who they are because TV shows them, an internet web page will show them. Through our credit card, we can easily pay somebody. There are da'wah organizations that are next door to us that will feed people in another country. So we are all a village. You cannot ever give the excuse anymore that, you know what, my neighbor's not hungry anymore. They are hungry, and there is approximately 960 million of them that are chronically hungry today in the year 2015. A lot of them are orphans, by the way. And so if you're looking for a good deed to do, And you're thinking, how can I please Allah Azza wa Jal? You don't have to look too hard. Allah's given you the answer. Go and feed people food. Go and find someone hungry. Go and find an organization like Charity Right or some other organization that is focused on feeding people food, and help those organizations and focus and feed the poor with them. I know Charity Right is running a campaign called the Feed 400 campaign, where with £400 you can look after a Muslim family for a whole year with food, alhamdulillah. And if you can join a campaign like that, that would be very blessed, inshallah. And if you can find any other campaign out there where people are feeding food, that is something very blessed to do. Jazakumullah khair. I hope Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives you the aqaba, and Allah writes for you on this day of judgment, on this day, freedom from Jahannam on the day of judgment. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala brings out loads of people, millions of people on the day of judgment to witness for you because you fed them food. Walhamdulillah. Jazakallah khair. Assalamu alaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.